Hey, what is up, you guys? It is Leo coming at you. I am super fired up to be on today. And I just wanted to show you guys a quick glimpse before we get into the meat of things. And since I moved into a new Airbnb home here, I just thought, you know what? Let me just give you guys a quick view. So you ready? 1, 2, 3. Alright, this is the view, you guys, from my balcony. You have no idea, like, this is such a dream come true for me. So I'm just excited to kind of share it with you guys. But today's message is going to be pretty simple. And if you guys haven't had a chance yet, make sure to go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell so that you do not miss any further videos. But I want to talk about rejection. Okay, rejection, yes. Like, that is the biggest issue I feel like as a human being we can have. Nobody wants to be rejected. Nobody wants to feel rejected, right, in any areas of their lives. But if we don't know how to overcome rejection, if we don't know how to deal with it effectively, that would cause us to feel stuck, right? Because we feel like, you know, woe is me. We attend pity party and we feel like nobody likes me. You know, there's nothing that I can do in order to please that person or these people, right? So, it took me a long time, guys, to learn this, but when I finally learned it, you know what my thought process is when I think about people who, you know, people who may not like me, who may not cheer for me, who may not agree with whatever I'm doing with my life. You know what I say? And I want you guys to practice this with me. Like, I don't give a rip. Can we say that one more time? I do not give a rip what you think, say, and how you talk negatively about me, how you go and gossip about me. Have at it, okay? Because I am literally pursuing the life that God has put on my heart. And I know that I am making an impact on other people, so it doesn't matter, right? So first thing is you have to kind of know who you are as a person. If you are struggling with your self-esteem and self-confidence, your self-image, you are going to battle for a long time, man, with rejection, right? So work on yourself, loving yourself. If you guys don't really have a routine of kind of like pouring into yourself and speaking good things about yourself and for yourself, I suggest that you start today. So something I say often, and I say this, you know, I used to say every single day because I was literally working on my self-image, right? Since I hated myself so much. I hated everything from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet, right? My skin color, my face, my height, everything. So I would look in the mirror every single day and I would say, I love you, Leo. I love you, Leo. And mind you, at that time, I did not feel love, right? I did not feel the feelings of love and appreciation for myself and all the stuff. But who gives a rip on how you feel? Did you guys know when it comes to our feelings, we cannot be too, you know, we cannot be, we cannot cater to them so much. We have to know when to enjoy our positive, happy, good feelings, right? But when we are dealing with negative feelings, the feelings of being rejected, even though we might feel rejected, but in actuality, nobody's rejecting you, for example, right? Or even if they reject you, it doesn't matter because you are learning how to accept yourself and you are approving of yourself, okay? So let's change, let's change the view here, or let's change angle here. So start with that, right? Learn how to accept yourself and tell yourself every day, I love you. I love you. Look in the mirror, point at yourself, and tell yourself that. You might not feel at first, but eventually these words are going to kind of come into your spirit, come into your heart and soul, and you're going to start believing them. And I have been doing this too with many of my mentees, and they have seen miraculous results. Okay, so that's number one. Number two is, you know, work on your self-confidence. Right? Be confident with what you are doing. I'll give you an example. When I was pursuing this business in 2007, because I wanted freedom. I didn't want to have to work for a job for the rest of my life, like 9 to 5 to the age of 65. Like, no, thank you. I wanted to have the freedom to travel the world. I still want to go make an impact in people's lives. I want to help people and serve people. I love to lead. I love to build people's confidence. And I just did not see that corporate America would be the answer for me. So when I was chasing after this opportunity, I was going out there and serving people every day. Sometimes I have to put my daughter, you know, to a babysitter or just let, you know, her dad take care of her or whatever. You know, not like I never see her or anything like that, but just I was just not a normal mom, you know, where I was staying home, just cooking, taking care of my daughter. It was not like that. Sometimes my daughter, you know, was with me and we were on the road together. We traveled together. We went from home to home to home and we just served people. And people thought I was nuts. Like they're thinking, you know, why are you chasing after money and fame and success and all that stuff? And I heard, you know, many messages from incredible leaders in that business. And one gentleman, he was the person who started the system. He says, success is not the cars or the houses or anything like that. But success is whose lives are better off because you lived. And ever since then, man, success has a new meaning for me. And I'm absolutely to walk that out nowadays. You know, I feel like I'm living a successful life and chasing after things that I love, chasing after, you know, making impact and just chasing after things that fulfill my desires, right? The desires of my heart. Okay, so number two is knowing what you're chasing after, right? And chase after the right things. Chase after where you can make an impact, like a real impact, a long-lasting impact in people's lives. Because when you are doing that, you know that you're doing the right thing with yourself, right? The right thing with your life. So even if people are saying this and that, it doesn't matter to you, okay? Number three is get around people who are cheering for you, who are believing in you, believing in your dreams and goals. They may not even travel on the same path, but they see that you are doing something with your life and that you are making a difference in other people's lives, right? And, you know, I learned in that business, I had to learn how to disassociate with people who did not believe in me and who were just kind of like a stumbling block for me, right? Who were causing me to feel very discouraged about what I was doing. Maybe, you know, what they say and how they are caused me to feel not good about who I am. So I had to learn how to let them go, right? And then also learning how to associate with people who are going places in life. They're going where you want to go. They're doing things that you want to do with your life, right? Look for those people, whether it be podcasts, look for a mentor, you know, on Instagram, on YouTube. I know I found my most recent mentor on YouTube and then Instagram, so I'm very grateful. Like, do they have the type of life that you want to have, right? If so, man, see how you can get in their inner circle. I'm not saying that, you know, you are doing your best to chase after them and, you know, be in their circle just, you know, just to kiss up. No, not like that. So that you can learn from them. So that you can continue to be inspired by them, right? So that you can continue to make progress in your life. So that way you are having a balance. You know, you might encounter negatives, you know, as you're out and about, you're doing things, you're encountering discouragement and all that stuff. But when you see that person's post, or you watch the videos, or you have a chance to be mentored by them, and you're having that weekly call with, they're gonna jack you up big time, man. You get off the phone and you're like, you know what? I don't give a rip what people are saying anymore. Like this week, it's gonna be productive for me. This week, I'm going to make it happen, right? So that is so important for you to associate with the right kind of people, okay? Number four, and I'm just gonna have five things. Number four is when it comes to rejection, guys, you have to understand that a lot of times they're not rejecting you as a person. So don't take rejections too personally. I'll give you an example. Let's say you go to a restaurant, right? You go to McDonald's and you order French fries and a burger, and the, you know, cashier asks you, hey, do you want some ketchup or mustard with your fries? And you're like, no, I don't care for that. And have you ever seen the cashier just bust out crying? Oh my gosh, I feel so rejected. You don't want any fries? You know, you don't want any ketchup with your burgers or fries? Why? You've never seen that, right? That's ridiculous if you were to see it. So we do face rejections on a daily basis. So it's just part of life. It's part of the journey, right? So the cashier just moves on. Okay, well, thank you so much, you know, for stopping in today at our McDonald's. I hope you have a great meal and have a great day. right? Move along, you know? And the cashier just continues with the next customer and continues with his or her job. So that should be for us as well. Okay, well, I am offering this product or this service. And if the person does not accept it, it's okay. Maybe they don't see it being valuable, right? It's not good for them at this very moment. You go find someone else, man. I firmly believe that if you have a product and a service that you want to release, that means people in the world are needing it, or they will need it very soon. That's why God is prompting you, right? To launch it, to go out and to put it together so that you can make this offer to people. I've been hearing this one phrase recently, and it means a lot to me. And it really is a source of encouragement to me when I am kind of, you know, afraid to launch out to do something new because I sense it in my heart. But I'm thinking, well, what if people don't like it, or people, I won't get any calls or any sales or anything like that, right? Or I won't have a mentee or something. And I heard it recently from Terry Savelle, and she's an incredible speaker. She says, somebody on the other side is waiting for your obedience. Someone on the other side is waiting for your obedience. That means when you send something or to do something and to launch out, that means people are waiting for you. If you obey and you launch this product, you launch a service, it's gonna be of help to them. Okay, so rejection is part of life, right? You are rejected. For example, let's say you're a guy, man, and you're pursuing this girl, right? You like her, you have a crush on her, but you're not her type, or she's not ready for a relationship or whatever. You're not gonna sit there and mope and cry and be depressed and say, okay, I will never like another girl again, right? That's stupid, that's silly, right? Sorry, not stupid, that's silly, okay? So it's all right, okay? You gotta start having that thought process that you are great with accepting rejections, that rejection is so normal, that you are so good at accepting rejections. Bring it on, man. I can slay it any time of the week, okay? And last but not least, when it comes to rejections, don't get into self-pity mode. It is so easy for us to feel, woe is me, I'm the only one that is dealing with this rejection. No, you're not the only one. We all deal with it every single day, no matter what profession, no matter what background. When you're at home, you offer your kid a meal and they said, no, I don't want rice, I want noodles, right? You cook for your husband, he's like, I'm not really into steak right now, honey. Can we just have, you know, maybe pho instead, or Indian food instead, or whatever, right? That is like a rejection sort of, because somebody doesn't want something that you're offering, right? But that's okay. You're like, okay, no big deal, right? I'll make that for you next time, or let's order out. You know what I mean? So just don't take it personally, okay? And when it comes to self-pity, it's such a low vibrational emotions, you guys. Don't go there. You know, I heard this one speaker says, pity party might invite you to the party, right? But don't go. Like, don't accept the invitation of going to the pity party, because it's not gonna be fun. You are just gonna feel down, your moods are gonna be low, your vibes are gonna be low, you have no energy, whatever. And you just feel like you're kind of sunk, you know, into something that is like deep and dark and, you know, just low emotions. And you don't wanna go there. The moment you are sensing like, okay, self-pity is trying to get a hold of me, it's trying to grip me, you're like, nope. I am not gonna feel sorry for myself. This is normal. I'm a champion. I can receive rejections with strength, right? And I receive it with a smile on my face, and I still go forward, okay? So I hope this message added a lot of value today. If it did, make sure to smash that like button. And of course, please take the time to share it with other people so that they also can benefit from this. But I hope you guys like enjoy this view with me while we chatted today. And my goal is to be creative, you know, as I produce these types of videos for you guys. I don't wanna just sit the same place, do the same thing, say the same thing and all that stuff. I wanna be creative versus me just sitting in front of like a set and just talking. So let me know in the comment below, okay? And also the reminder is that I am going to finish off with my mentorship program, you know, by the end of September. I'm launching something new. I'm really excited about that. So I can't wait to, you know, share more details with you guys. But I wanna remind you that I am proud of you. I'm proud of you for, you know, you may not be where you need to be yet, but you're not where you used to be. You're okay and you're on your way to bigger and better things in your life. Okay, so with that, guys, I love you guys. I respect you guys so much. And I know that you guys are making things happen with your life. So with that, over and out from Da Nang.